We are now ready to learn how dynamic programming algorithms work for finding optimal passes in the graphs. Let's start from this graph and let's try to figure out how to move in this graph to reach the sink with the maximum number of attraction. At every step, there are only two decisions to make, either to move vertically or move horizontally, south or east. So to arrive to the final destination, we can either arrive by moving south or moving east. And let's define a variable which is south or east of I, j, as the length of the longest path from the initial node, node 0, 0, to node I, j in the grid. And of course, we can immediately write a simple recursive program for computing south or east for nm, for the source final destination vertex. It is simply minimum of south or east of n minus 1 m plus weight of the vertical edge into the final node, or south or east of n m minus 1 plus weight of horizontal edge into the final node. And as soon as we realized it, there is a very simple recursive algorithm for computing the optimal path to node ij, and the algorithm is called south or east. And the only thing this algorithm does is compute alternative between two scenarios: moving to node ij using vertical edge or moving to node ij using horizontal edge. Do you think this algorithm will solve our problem? If you watch me when I explain the change problem, you will figure out that this algorithm, while being correct, will take enormous time to finish, because we will be making recursive calls many, many times for a fixed value of I and j. And therefore, we need to come up with something better, and let's try to do apply dynamic programming idea for traveling in this grid. Well, the optimal path to reach node 0, of course, we will see only 0 attractions, so the score in this node will be 0. The score in this node will be 1, because there is only one way to reach this node, by moving vertically. The optimal score to reach this node will be 5, which is 1 plus 4, because there is no other alternative. And as a result, we can compute all values which describe the length of the longest path for the first row and the first column on this graph. Now something interesting starts. What is the best way to reach this node in the graph, the node 1, 1? Should we move to this node using horizontal or vertical, south or east? Well, if we move horizontally into this node, then the length of the path will be 1 plus 3. And if we move vertically, the length of the path will be 3 plus 0. Of course, we choose to move horizontally because 1 plus 3 is larger than 3 plus 0. And we know afterwards that optimal path to this node has length 4. And for the future, we represent the edge, horizontal edge that we use to reach this node as the bold edge. And we will see later why it is important. How about this edge? The same argument, and we decide to move to this node by using vertical edge in this case. And we'll continue further and further. Let's just try one more time. What about this node? How should we arrive to this node? In this case, we compare 4 plus 2 with 5 plus 2. 5 plus 2 is larger than 4 plus 2. And therefore, if we choose to arrive to this node by moving along vertical edge. Therefore, the recurrency for computing the longest passes is the following. We define Sij as the length of the longest path from initial node to ij. And Sij is simply maximum of Si minus yj plus the weight of the vertical edge, or Sij minus 1 plus the weight of the horizontal edge. And after we finish this dynamic programming procedure, we will fill the value of longest passes for every node, and we'll learn that the optimal path to the final destination has length 34. When we are doing this, please note that in some cases, instead of making decision south or east, we will make a decision south and east. For example, in this particular node, we are comparing 22 plus 0, which is equal to 20 plus 2, which means that both horizontal and vertical edge entering into this vertex are in bold. And now, I hope it will become clear why we were retaining information about bold edges. Because 34, the number in the last node, tells us the length of the longest path. But it doesn't tell us how this longest path was traversing the graph. But with bold edges, we can figure out. Because we know that we arrive to the last node marked by 34 by moving along horizontal bold edge. Here it is. We arrive in the node marked, labeled by 32, once again by moving by horizontal edge, and we arrive to this node labeled by 30 by moving along vertical edge. We continue backtracking in this way, and sooner or later we will arrive in the initial node, and the blue path shown on this slide is actually an optimal path from the initial to final destination in this graph. And we now move from describing how dynamic programming works in a simple Manhattan grid to describing how it works in arbitrary alignment graphs.